being here this afternoon, and I appreciate all of you coming as we talk about this significant investigation that occurred here in Seminole County, led by the Seminole County Sheriff's Office. As you know, in Seminole County, we take pride in our high quality of life, our historically low crime rates, and the unique relationship that we have with our local, state, and federal partners, as well as the community that we serve. Anytime that there is a significant event that demonstrates a blatant lack of consideration of quality of life and is crime-related, it not only affects the family and the individuals, but creates a well-rounded concern for the fear of crime as well. And we take those situations to heart anytime that we're exposed to that and do our best to make sure that we solve those crimes and lower those fears associated with that. With that in mind, I'm here to announce that we have made a total of 13 arrests associated with a high-profile case from January of 2023, which was a drive-by shooting, leaving one person deceased and five others wounded. While the case is incredibly complicated and the investigative tools and methods used were complex, I want to commend our team here at the Seminole County Sheriff's Office who worked day in and day out to bring justice in this case, hold those responsibles accountable to the fullest extent of the law, and then ultimately make our community safer as a result of their work and effort. I do want to take a moment to provide some historical background on the case, the investigation, and ultimately charges that we announced today. As you recall, the incident occurred on January 16, 2023, in the late night, early morning hours, after a concert was being held at the barn in Sanford, an incident that, as you recall, was widely covered and reported on by local news media as well as national news media. The artist performing that night was Pierre Delance, a rapper who goes by the stage name Jack Boy. Following his performance, a group left the venue in two separate vehicles, heading towards Orlando on County Road 46A in the direction of Interstate 4. One of those vehicles in the caravan was a Mercedes-Benz Sprinter van occupied by 13 people. We know from experience and history that Jack Boy frequently travels with a large group or entourage of people, including personal security members for his organization and his team, as well as promoters that are with him. The Sprinter van was following behind an SUV that Jack Boy was actually traveling in those early morning hours. At approximately 2:20 in the morning, deputies in the area of County Road 46A and Reinhardt Road in unincorporated Seminole County heard gunshots in the vicinity where they were located. They observed several vehicles at the intersection of 46A approaching Reinhardt Road and witnessed multiple gunshots being fired towards the Sprinter van of what appeared to be coming from a dark-colored four-door passenger vehicle. That is when deputies noticed a black Nissan, which they believed to be connected to the incident. Deputies attempted to perform a blocking-in maneuver with their patrol vehicles when the suspect's vehicle sped up and attempted to flee. However, we were able to successfully block in that Nissan to prevent the driver from escaping. A subsequent search of that vehicle yielded numerous .223 armor-piercing rounds, which matched the caliber of the cartridges later found on the roadway where the shooting occurred. While the deputies were engaging with the driver of that Nissan vehicle, the driver of the Sprinter van drove directly to a nearby hospital, believing that it was not safe to pull over on the side of the road and want to ensure that the victims inside of the van were treated as quickly as possible. Upon arrival at the hospital, it was determined that six female occupants that were traveling in that van were shot and wounded, six of the 13. Princess Tolliver, 31 years of age, from Tallahassee, Florida, a civilian employee of the Florida State University Police Department, sadly died as a result of her injuries. The other five victims were treated and eventually released from the hospital. Ms. Tolliver has been in our area and was in our area for the weekend, and she was simply out that night enjoying time with her friends, enjoying a concert. Her murder was the result of the criminal actions of others who demonstrated a total disregard for human life. In fact, our detectives have determined that none of the victims were the intended target that night. We found that the likely motive for the incident stemmed from a very public, high-profile dispute playing out on social media and in the court system involving Jack Boy and a known associate of the shooters, another rap artist, Bill Capri, known by the stage name Kodak Black. At this time, Capri is not currently facing any charges in Seminole County, and we do not have any evidence that he is directly linked to this crime. Our investigation found that the shooters thought that Jack Boy was a passenger in the van and was likely the intended target of the shooting. Those arrested in this investigation are members of a criminal street gang known as OTF, On Top Forever, with a known presence here in Seminole County. OTF is a known subset of the National Gangsters Murder Crip Street Gang. Seminole County policing authorities, along with state and federal partners, have been investigating the activities of this gang and its members for the past decade. This includes our domestic security, gang intelligence, and suppression unit here at the Seminole County Sheriff's Office. Since 2021, we have arrested 43 known or associated members of OTF on 148 offenses unrelated to this investigation. These charges include involvement in other shootings, drugs, weapons, and other serious criminal activities, targeting and involving a lot of folks that are also engaged in similar criminal activities. As you can imagine, our detectives poured an incredible amount of time and effort into going through all of the small details of this case and worked nonstop for the past 13 months. Through conventional investigative tools and modern technology, we were able to piece together this investigation, obtaining more than 120 search warrants, allowing us to put some dangerous individuals behind bars for very serious crimes. We have determined who was in each of the six vehicles that were involved during that particular early morning incident, two of which were stolen vehicles. We determined their direction of travel, their weapons used, the pattern of movements that were all involved in this heinous crime. All of this will be outlined in a nearly 500-page affidavit will be later made available at a different date after we conclude the full redactions of that 500-page affidavit, or nearly 500-page affidavit, and we will make sure that we release that to the public and the members of the media as soon as we have the opportunity to go through that. Last Friday morning, our domestic security gang intelligence and suppression unit, with the assistance of the U.S. Marshal Services, the Orlando Police Department, the Orange County Sheriff's Office, we were able to arrest 8 suspects and take them into custody. Another 5 were already in custody on court-ordered or on court-ordered supervision for unrelated charges, including one who is currently serving prison time in North Carolina on felony firearms charges. These 5 individuals have been now charged for their involvement in this case that I'm briefing on this afternoon. It is crucial to highlight our knowledge and findings of the majority of these suspects, as they are considered, all of them, to be incredibly dangerous individuals. They all have prior criminal history, and many of them with serious, dangerous pasts. The charges are as follows. Ravonte Daniels and Trayvon Whitaker are charged with 1 count of first-degree premeditated murder, 5 counts of attempted first-degree premeditated murder, 1 count on unlawful use of a two-way communication device, and then 1 count of RICO for the racketeering involvement with this organized crime group. Rayquarius Davis, Robin Hickman Jr., Quadarius Holly, Quavon Watson, and John Williams, Ja Michael Wright, are charged with first-degree premeditated murder, 5 counts of attempted first-degree premeditated murder, 1 count of unlawful use of a two-way communication device, 1 count of electronic communication promoting a criminal gang, and then, of course, RICO as the last charge, 1 count. Alvarez Cosby, currently in federal custody in North Carolina, will be eventually extradited to Seminole County Sheriff's Office and booked into the John E. Polk Correctional Facility on the following charges: one count of first-degree premeditated murder, 5 counts of attempted first-degree premeditated murder, 1 count of unlawful use of a two-way communication device, 1 count of directing the activities of a criminal gang, 1 count of RICO, and 1 count of electronic communication promoting gang activity. Thallus Immon and Darren Siplin are charged with 1 count of first-degree premeditated murder, 5 counts of attempted first-degree premeditated murder, 1 count of unlawful use of a two-way communication device, 1 count of grand theft auto, and 1 count of RICO. Additionally, Danica Hare was charged with 1 count of perjury in prosecution of a capital offense, and Valerie Smith was charged with 1 count of accessory after the fact to a capital felony. Both females are currently in custody here in Seminole County at the John E. Polk Correctional Facility. It's important to note that we still have one individual who is outstanding at this time. Everybody else has been arrested. The person who is outstanding is Trayvon Law. Law's charges include 1 count of first-degree premeditated murder, 5 counts of attempted first-degree premeditated murder, 1 count of unlawful use of a two-way communication device, and the last charge is RICO charge, racketeering. Seminole County detectives are actively looking for and following up on leads to locate Law at this time. If you have any information about Trayvon Law's whereabouts, we ask that you please contact us with that information or call Crimeline at 1-800-423-TIPS or *TIPS. Tips provided to Crimeline are obviously anonymous, and you could be eligible for a reward. By now, it goes without saying that Law should be considered dangerous, and citizens should contact law enforcement officers with any information that they have about his whereabouts. Although these types of incidents in Seminole County are rather unusual, we utilize all available resources to make sure that we're doing what we can to solve these cases. We work to locate these individuals and to ensure that the street gang activity, acts, and behaviors are not tolerated within our community. We don't do this alone. Our local partners all agree with this philosophy and invest all of their resources and efforts to make sure that we can accomplish that. Once we locate Trayvon Law, our investigation in this case will be completed. Unless additional information becomes available, again, the Office of the State Attorney's 18th Judicial Circuit will be prosecuting this case, and I want to thank them for their hard work with our investigators as well. Finally, I want to express our deepest condolences to the victims, and in particular, Princess Tolliver's family, as they continue to grieve her loss. Princess's father, Ed, is here with us today, and her mother has asked us to release a statement on her behalf, which we will make available at the conclusion of this press conference. While these arrests do not bring your daughter back, I hope that you're able to find some solace in knowing that the suspect's fate are now in the hands of the justice system. Please know our thoughts and prayers are with you and your family, and have been during this tragic incident and horrible, horrible loss. Again, with that, it's a complicated, in-depth investigation that has involved many organizations. I want to thank the leaders on our case, our detectives, our investigators, our partnership with the State Attorney's Office. When you talk about 13 months and the amount of search warrants, this is probably one of the most significant follow-up investigations that we've had here in the history of the Seminole County Sheriff's Office, and I want to commend them for that. So with that, there will be a lot of information that is going to be released to you. A lot of information, as you can imagine, with a 13-month investigation that you'll have to go through. And as soon as we can get that nearly 500-page affidavit redacted and released to you, you will have that with you as well. So with that, I'll open for questions that I can answer for you.
Sheriff, did these suspects, did they believe they would profit somehow financially from this, or was this because because they thought they were doing someone a favor? I mean, how did all this add up?
So we don't know the answer to the question of what their individual motive was as far as whether or not they were paid for this. We don't believe that they were paid for this. We do believe, as a newly established Crips organization, they were looking for street validation. It was clear that they had been watching this very public debate between Kodak Black and Jack Boy, which was not only playing out on social media and in other forms of entertainment media, but also in the court system, and probably took this as an opportunity to make a name for themselves working in this space. The investigation did not reveal that there was any financial compensation or that Kodak Black had arranged direct involvement with them to do this. This entire case is incredibly frightening, to think that we look at nothing more than people coming in to Seminole County from out of the area, want to spend time with friends, go to a concert. I mean, things that most people have done. And at 2:20 in the morning, to be the victim of a drive-by shooting with 223 armor-piercing rifle rounds is incredibly frightening. I think that when we look at this thing, any person who is a witness to this is going to have some concerns. Gang activity has always been a problem throughout this country, and you look at the amount of cases that we've made simply on this OTF organization. Now, the good news is, with all of these arrests and taking out some of the leaders of this organized criminal enterprise, it's absolutely going to make Seminole County in Central Florida a much safer place. Okay. Thank you for being here, and God bless you and your family. You'll always be a part of this organization, anything we can do to help you. And again, one-on-one, whatever information we have to release, I'm sure in the coming days we'll be able to do that. So thank you all, and thank you to all the investigators back there in the back that really worked hard and made sure that we can take some very, very bad people off the streets. Thank you.